he's just as dead at 36 as he would be at 80. And the state of breathing in his life is merely the announcement of an earlier death of the spirit. King roused the crowd for the next day on Pettus Bridge. "We must let them know that if they beat one Negro, they are going to have to beat 100," he declared. "And if they beat 100, then they're going to have to beat 1,000. President Johnson, meanwhile, had decided to take a very firm line with King. Frenzied efforts to prevent repetition of Sunday's violence continued through Monday night, as Johnson's intermediaries wrestled earnestly with King over prospects for the voting rights movement. Each side said the other could tip a precarious balance from disastrous collision just ahead to historic triumph. Johnson's side demanded a peaceful respite to shore up national consensus, while King insisted he was too deeply committed to call off the march without tangible signs of support from Washington. The balance of nerves seesawed as they exchanged blandishments, professions of respect, and outright threats, but only hints of their struggle seeped outside private councils. Early Tuesday morning, March 9th, Assistant Attorney General John Doerr, head of the Justice Department's Civil Rights Division, arrived in Selma and met with King.